Although the Rebel is not a new model of the Honda's lineup, it was born in 2018, but for this year, 2020, it got a lot of innovations, so we would like to show you the bike from the beginning till the end. The bike we got for the test has a lot of extra features which are not included to the basic model, but the most important technical changes are the same here as on the basic one as well. All the lights are LED system now. The front one has these four light very well looking and well seeable version. All the indicators are LED and the rear light as well. The whole rear section also changed. And what are the specifics of this special edition is this small wind protection cover, which is really looking beautiful. The cover of the front forks and this very special, we can say, rider seat. The engine itself didn't change related to the previous Rebel version. The cubic capacity is the same as in the other 500 cubic centimeter Hondas. It's exactly 471 cubic centimeter, but the power is a little bit less. It's instead of 48, it's 46 brake horsepower. The torque is the same, 43 newton meter. And the whole working system of the engine is a little bit different because the low RPM torque is a bit higher than in the other two versions, the X and the Sporty version. So the let's say cruising rideability of the bike is a little bit better. And another very important change is that as the whole exhaust system was changed, this model already knows the Euro 5 norms. And the sound of this new silencer is the same way, pretty deep and pretty nice as in the previous model was. The Rebel, just as on the same way as the other two 500 cubic centimeter Hondas, got the slipper and assist clutch, which means that this is a very good thing for especially the beginner riders, that the force of the clutch, of the working of the clutch, is extremely low, really low. One finger is enough for moving it. And the slipper clutch is also very useful if you are not accustomed to the throttle beep down changing of the gears, because if you change without using the throttle beep, then the blocking of the rear wheel is really minimized. First, we were riding with the bike, both of us who were testing it, and only read the technical details and the innovations afterwards, and that we were feeling was absolutely fitting what Honda is writing about the new Rebel. The front suspension has the same technical details, but the preload is a little bit more, although the damping is maybe even a little bit softer than the previous models was. So it's pretty close to comfortable, but a little bit more sporty rides are also available with it. The rear suspension elements were absolutely rebuilt. The preload can be changed in 5 steps, and that part is also working on a pretty comfortable and a bit sporty way. So it's really nice and good for the everyday public roads. Only the bigger positive bumps are hitting you a little bit more than we would say it's comfortable. If we watch the brakes, the Rebel is absolutely fitting to the other 500 Hondas. In the front we have a simple, and in the rear we also have a simple disc brake. In the front a 2-piston, and in the rear a 1-piston caliper. And we have two different brake lines and ABS on both wheels, fortunately. And of course it's fitting to the lows as well. And what is very important is the front tire, which is a relatively fat tire. It's a 130 millimeter wide one, and it means that the bike is really looking absolutely great as a bobber style motorbike, but all the details of it are very perfect for the beginner riders or the ladies as well. I already mentioned that the rider seat is pretty low, 690 millimeters from the gravel, so lots of short riders are going to love this bike. For a guy like me who is 190 centimeters, it's absolutely not comfortable. So who are tall as me, forget the Rebel. We show with my colleague Ákos that he is 180, just 10 centimeters shorter than me, that for him is still a good bike, but he is, we can say, the top of the heights, which is fitting to the Honda Rebel. We can change the different functions of the menu with the button on the side of the dashboard like this, and it's worth to speak one sentence about all the buttons on the handlebars, because they are extremely nice and very good quality feeling buttons. Nothing complicated, everything is simple and clear, but really the whole bike's quality, just as these buttons, are on the top. So all in all, we can say that the new Honda Rebel, from all the points, became a better bike than its previous version was in the past 2 years. It's a very good choice for the short riders, the ladies, the beginners, and nearly everybody under or up to 180 centimeters, who is not related to the speed, the 300 km per hour running with a motorbike, but every Sunday wants to cruise nice and good with his or her bike. For this purpose, the Rebel is a very good choice. If you liked our review, please push a thumb up on it. Under the film you can find the description with the link where you can donate our work. If you do it, then we send all of our films to you before they become public. If you haven't done it yet, please subscribe for our channel and watch our previous films, tests and reviews as well. Thanks a lot for your kind attention.